Hi students, today we are going to discuss some synopsis in mechanical properties of solids. First we have to know about rigid body. What is it? If the shape and size of a body doesn't change, even a large amount of force was applied on it, then the body is known as rigid body. Next, deformation force. Deformation force. What is it? It is a force by which the shape and size of the body changes. Then it is known as deformation force. Next, restoring force. What is it? It is the force by which the body regains its shape and size to its original. Even deformation force is removed, then it is known as restoring force. Next one, elasticity. Here one thing, the deformation and restoring forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction, but they do not form action and reaction pairs. Here, restoring force is the responsibility for elastic nature of the body. What is elasticity? Yes, it is a property of material by which it regains its original shape and size. Even deformation force is removed, then the nature is known as elasticity nature. Okay, steel and rubber are example for elastic nature. What is plasticity? So you know elasticity. Here in elasticity, the material regains its original shape and the size even after removing of the deforming force. But here it is not done. That means the shape and size of the body doesn't regain its original shape. Then the nature is known as plasticity. Clay and putty are the examples of plastic nature. Next we see about stress. What is stress? Stress is nothing but force acting on unit area of cross section. Force per unit area of cross section is known as stress. Okay, this is nothing but restoring force per unit area of cross section. This is stress. Acidity is Newton per meter square or Pascal. There are three types of stresses are there. One is longitudinal stress. Second one is volume stress or bulk stress. Third one is shearing stress. In every case, stress is nothing but force acts on unit area of cross section. In the case of longitudinal stress, by the applying force, there is a change in length of the material. In such case, stress is known as longitudinal stress. In the case of bulk stress, volume changes. In the case of shear stress, the shape of the body only changes. In these two cases, longitudinal and bulk stress, only size of the body will change. In the shear stress, the shape of the body will change. Okay, just remembering the points. Now, discuss about strain. What is strain? If you apply some force on a metal of a body, there is a change in the dimensions. Now the ratio of change in dimension to its original dimension. So the ratio of change changing dimension to original dimension is nothing but strain. In the strain also three types. First one is longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain. Second one, bulk strain. Third one, shearing strain. Okay, in every case, the strain is changing dimension to original dimension. In the case of longitudinal strain, this is change in length by original length. So delta is the change in the length, or it can be written as small elongation by original length here. In the case of bulk strain, change in volume by original volume, delta V by. In the case of shearing strain, we write, suppose a rectangular plate was taken initially, a tangential force capital acts on the upper surface, then its shape is changed only so that the upper surface was displaced like that. The relative displacement is considered as delta x and the distance between two layers is considered as L. Then this angle phi is known as the shearing strain. Here shearing strain is phi is equal to delta x by L. So we discussed it now, stress and strain completely. Now see Hooke's law. What is the statement of Hooke's law? Within the elastic limit, within the elastic limit, that means the maximum stress applied below which the body regained its original shape and size, then the limit is known as elastic limit. The statement of Hooke's law is within elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. Once again, stress is directly proportional to strain. Now, stress is equal to some constant, that is nothing but modulus of elasticity, E, into strain. So here, E is known as modulus of elasticity. Now E can be written as stress by strain. Stress by strain. Now here SI unit of modulus of elasticity is stress units here Newton per meter square and strain has no units because it is the ratio of same physical quantities. That's why strain has no units. Finally, modulus of elasticity has units Newton per meter square or simply Pascal. There are three types of modulus of elasticity. One is Young's modulus of elasticity. Young's modulus of elasticity. What is it? It is nothing but, it is represented by letter of y, it is nothing but the ratio between longitudinal stress and longitudinal strain. You know, modulus of elasticity is stress by strain. What is Young's modulus of elasticity? This is longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain. If applying force is acting on a body due to that change in length only, then you take X modulus of elasticity, Y is equal to longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain. Now Y is equal to longitudinal stress is F by A, force per unit area, by longitudinal strain is E by L, change in length by original length. Finally we get FL by AE. So Y is equal to FL by AE. Or Y can be written also Y is equal to, instead of F, right, MG, weight of the body, into L by AE. Or FL is same, A is the area of cross section of the wire. This is nothing but pi r square into E. R F is mg into L by A is pi r square into E. So these formulas are very helpful to practice in our problems. Okay, this is about Young's modulus of elasticity. Second one is bulk modulus of elasticity. This is represented by letter of K. This is nothing but bulk stress by bulk strain. Bulk stress by bulk strain. Now K is equal to bulk stress is nothing but force per unit area by bulk strain is change in volume by original volume. Here force per unit area is nothing but pressure in the case of volume. So that's why F by A is replaced by pressure P. By delta V by V, this can be written as dV by delta V. So this is formula for bulk modulus of elasticity. Now see, modulus of rigidity, modulus of elasticity. Rigidity modulus of elasticity. This is represented by letter of eta is equal to shearing stress by shearing strain. Shearing stress is F by A into shearing strain is phi. This is eta. Okay. Now we see compressibility. Compressibility. This is the reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity 1 by A. So this is delta V by PV. Okay, compressibility is reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity. Okay. Next we see Poisson's ratio. But lateral contraction strain to longitudinal elongation strain KK by like this, whose length is L and radius is smaller initially. Now applying a tangential force in this direction, then it becomes thin. That means now it is look like that. Okay, now its length was increased. How much delta L? And radius was decreased. How much delta R? Here laterally it contracts, but longitudinally it elongates. Now we take lateral contraction and longitudinal elongation ratio is nothing but Poisson's ratio. Here it can be written as Poisson's ratio sigma is equal to delta R by R. This is change in radius by original radius. Laterally radius will change, by longitudinally length will change. That's why delta L by L in the denominator. Here radius will decrease, that's why equal to minus. Finally sigma is equal to minus delta R into L by R into delta L. This is Poisson's ratio. It has no units. You know the relation between y, eta and k is 9 by pi is equal to 1 by k plus 3 by eta. Take this relation also. Now we find the work done in a stretched string. In the case of string, applied force is directly proportional to elongation x. Now F is equal to Ks. Okay, K is the spring constant or force constant, x is the elongation. Now in the case for elongation, the work done is F by 2 into x force into elongation, because initially the amount of force is considered 0, then there is no elongation. So getting of elongation x, to applied force gradually increases. That's why we take the average of the force into elongation. So work done is equal to F by 2 into x. Instead of x, put kx by 2 into x. Finally, the work done in the case of stretch string is half kx squared. This is nothing but potential energy stored in the stretch string. So u is equal to half kx squared. This can be written in the form of potential energy u is equal to half into F into elongation is considered as E. We also this one, potential energy stored in the string is half F into E. Now this can be multiplied by AL by AL. Now we write half F by A into E by L into AL. Now half into F by A is nothing but stress. Into E by L is nothing but strain. Into A into L, area of cross section length of the wire is nothing but volume. So potential energy or work done by stretch string is half into stress into strain into volume. Suppose the energy stored per unit volume can be written as half into stress into strain only. Now U by V, this means the potential energy per unit volume in a stretch string is also written as half into, in the case of stress here we write Y into strain also, Y into strain into here again strain. So finally we get U by V is equal half Y into strain squared. And also written as U by V is equal to half into stress into instead of strain, right? Stress by Y. So U by V is equal stress square by 2Y. So this is also another formula. Here U by V is the potential energy stored per unit volume in the stretch string. Is stress square by 2y or half y into strain square or half stress into strain. All these formulas are keep in mind and do the problems very easily. Okay,